everybody, it's me, Keisha, and this is my YouTube channel. And basically, I just want to talk about depression, something that nobody don't never talk about, and sometimes people like to keep it in. Depression is very hard, and I found out that I was depressed almost 3 years ago. I went to the doctor. You know, they ask you different questions, and I was just letting them know like how I was feeling, and they diagnosed me with depression. And I was very stressed. I was very unhappy. During that time, I was married, and I just wasn't happy. It felt like I could never accomplish anything that I tried to do, and I used to get stressed a lot. It was just hard, and it's kind of hard to explain. And it's good when you have somebody in your corner to talk to, because when you're depressed, sometimes it's kind of hard to keep it in, and that's what I learned. So 3 years ago I was diagnosed with depression, and 2 years ago I was diagnosed with anxiety and panic attacks. I started getting those after my divorce, and they started getting worse and worse, and I noticed that I was losing a lot of weight. And with depression and having panic attacks, it's just not a mixed combination. And I wasn't eating. I was very, very sick. Like, my bones were just like really showing, and I was like down to like 135 pounds. Well, now I'm 195, but yeah. But I was 135 pounds. I was a size 5. And I just didn't look right. People knew that I was very depressed. I didn't eat. I didn't want to do like no type of activities. You know, even when I got kids, I didn't want to really do anything. I just wanted to just lay down and wait for the next day. And then when the next day come, I want to lay down and wait for the next day. So I don't know if some people could relate, but that was me. During my 3 years after my divorce, I went to a different doctor, and she gave me medicine that I should take, and I started taking it, and yeah, it worked. That's all I can say. Yeah, actually. So they prescribed me medicine, and this is it. So this, I have bad ass reflux, so I could take this is to help with my acid reflux. So I take one a day. I'm on this is, well, I don't take this. I don't need this. So this is out. This is for depression. This is for, I am also diagnosed with IBS. That's irritable bowel syndrome, and it's dealing with my bowels. I have to take this every single day because of my bowels. I have a slow tracking system as well, and sometimes I can't use the bathroom like how everybody else use it. So I have to take this, well, 4 times a day, but sometimes I take it 3 times a day. And it's for the cramping, because I cramp real bad, like I'm having a baby. So I have to take these every day. So that's depression. This is for anxiety and panic attack. This is for, I have insomnia. I can't sleep at night, so I have to take this only when I go to bed. I don't take this all the time because they said it's a narcotic and it's very addictive. So when I'm off, I'll take it. If I'm not, I don't take it. And I take these every day. These are B12. I take these only to give me energy. Me taking all of this is hard, so I try to take B12 to get some energy. But like I was saying, depression is very real, and I feel like if you feel like you're depressed, please go get help, because the medicine that they gave me, it actually helped. I have my panic attacks sometimes, but that's only if I'm not taking my medicine. With depression, sometimes I can get into the mode, but not really. The medicine that they just gave me actually helped me with my depression. They said it's gonna take a month to see it, so I gotta wait, because I'm just now starting taking those. But people don't know what I go through, because I always, like, they always see me smiling and, you know, laughing and giggling and stuff like that. But when I'm home and I'm behind closed doors, like, I'm very, like, just down, and it's so hard. Like, I don't know. And the only thing that could kind of keep me, like, from not being depressed is writing. Like, if I watch a movie, I'm not thinking about it. What else? I love making wigs. So I'm making wigs and stuff like that. My mind is occupied, so I don't really think about stress or anything like that. But if only I could have caught it in time, because during my marriage, I was very depressed and I was very unhappy. Nothing could make me happy in the marriage, and that sucks. But it's over and done with. But anywho, and I know people might be like, this girl is taking a lot of medicine, but my doctor prescribed me those, and it's okay. I haven't OD'd yet, so I take it like I'm supposed to. And you'll be amazed. It's people that's older people, like in a nursing home and stuff like that, take more than that. But no, I don't. I haven't OD'd or anything. So that's basically it. If you're depressed, just go get help. My story is very long, and I'm gonna have to just make another video on it. But I just wanted to tell people a little bit as far as what I have. I have IBS, I have panic attacks, I have anxiety, and I have depression. But yeah. And that's basically it. Am I proud of it? No, I'm not. I wish I could get cured, but I guess maybe one day. But I just wanted to just share that with y'all, and I'm pretty sure that there's other people out there that's going through the same thing. I feel like this mute is depressed. Like everybody told me, find a hobby. Find something that you love to do. And I think that would be good. Because me, like, making wigs and just me writing and stuff like that, it helps me. So maybe if you have a hobby or you like something that you like doing, maybe that can help. Yeah. So that's basically it, y'all. So like, subscribe, follow me. I don't mind, you know, helping anybody. I'm a listener, so if somebody's going through something, I would listen. I would try my best to give advice, but at the same time, I'm not an expert because I'm going through something myself. But yeah.